welcome back to a long awaited prattle and plan. It's me, Emma, and Joan is here with me. She will be here in a few minutes. She's just sitting in the wings. Now, just as I've started this introduction, I am feeling a little bit self-conscious about something, and I have a few life updates for you. So many of you would have noticed that it seemed like, and it felt like to me, that I took most of the summer off. During that time, I had an operation. The operation went well. It took me a little bit longer to recover than I expected, but all is well. During that process, I was a bit of a sucker for punishment, and I went out and had myself fitted for a brace, an invisible brace. It's something that I've always wanted to do. As my wisdom teeth came through, like many people, it distorted the placement of my teeth and I started to get overcrowding. Now, as you will hear, I have a slight lisp, and some words I am finding that I'm having to relearn how to pronunciate while I have the brace in. The system is from Smile Direct. I have to wear the invisible aligners for 22 hours a day. During that time, I can drink clear liquids, can't have hot liquids or anything else. Now, when we normally talk, we talk through our teeth. We don't necessarily realise that we do, you know, air escapes, and it helps with the pronunciation. The same with where you place your tongue on the inside of your mouth. Now, the first probably week, I was a little bit like, oh, I'm finding some of these words are really, really strange. I'm not able to pronounce certain things. How is that going to work on my videos? So I also took a couple of weeks to be able to get myself used to talking with my brace in. So if you hear the odd word that sounds a little bit maybe like I'm slurring, I promise you I am not slurring my words, I am not doing a prattle and plan with a glass of something nice. It's just my brace. And when I get to the end of this journey, which, fingers crossed, if my teeth track correctly, should be in February. It's around about the second week in February. It's not guaranteed. I am a person in her 30s.
We're in our 30s now.
Well, I'm only just 30. Are you... You must... 39?
No, both in our 30s. Is the fact. Yeah.
And my teeth will not move like they would have done if I'd have had this done earlier. We are now here for this week's Prattle and Plan. Now, I'm not sure if you may have guessed this week's theme. It's subtle. It is subtle. I'm gonna do a little thing about Barbie, and I'm also gonna do a little thing about this. Now, here's a bit of a backstory for you. I follow an amazing YouTube creator, and her name is Sarah from Just My Typewriter. And it was actually Sarah that influenced my decision to not go and buy the We Are Memory Keepers typewriter, because for a long time it sat in my basket and I hummed and hard. I didn't know if I wanted to go down the route of what I would call a replica, a modern replica of older machines. And she had an amazing video actually on the We Are Typewriters ribbons, in which she talked about the ribbons and she did kind of like an in-store shot of the actual typewriters. And just recently, she has done a review on the We Are Memory Keepers typewriters. Something for you to go and have a look at if it's something that you have been wondering about. She does a very, very fair analysis and review of both a We Are Memory Keepers brand new typewriter versus an original from, say, the 1930s, 40s, 50s, 60s, etc. Anyway, on one of Sarah's videos, she was talking about what she had been looking for in the form of her Holy Grail typewriter. And it is the Barbie Enigma typewriter. Now, many of you may actually remember this typewriter because it appears to have been something that was very, very popular in the UK, in Europe, in the very late 90s and the very, very early 2000s. That makes me feel very old. Sarah was looking for the Barbie Enigma typewriter. It was mainly sold in Toys R Us, which of course is a name now that doesn't exist. So Sarah had been looking online on like Facebook Marketplace, on some auction sites, and they were actually fetching quite a large amount of money because it doesn't seem to be something that was produced for the American market. I contacted her and I said, look, I occasionally actually see these on Facebook Marketplace. They don't seem to go for very much. I imagine that most of them have ended up in landfill. They are, you know, they are an electric, highly plastic, but really cute item that is around about 21 years old now. If I see one, I will let you know and then we will go from there. Well, if you switch over to her channel, she will now fill you in on that part of the adventure of her Holy Grail typewriter. I am not going to give away any more details. I hope you really enjoy it. Sarah has made some really, really lovely stickers on Redbubble, and they are available to everybody worldwide. And this sticker here is the typewriter, saying no more than that. Okay? And this is going to go onto my plan this week. As you can see, I have also kind of done a combination here. Well, I will be doing a combination here of a stickerless stroke, adding a small sticker onto my spread. I will include how to print onto your Happy Planner spreads. Now, I just want to have a quick little chat about Barbie because I like to include a little bit of information. I have been doing my research because I'm good like that, and that sounds like I'm really bigging up myself. Anyway, Barbie has actually had over 200 careers. I mean, girl's been busy. I mean, she's not even at retirement age. Barbie is now 62. It has been estimated that through all of Barbie's careers and her jobs and bits and pieces that she's done, she should have accrued around about $42 million in the bank, obviously if all of her roles were paid. Barbie's career has spanned from being an astronaut, like you do, a pilot, a firefighter, a journalist. She has been many teachers, including a sign language teacher, a Spanish teacher, a special needs teacher, a ballet teacher. Of course, she's been a surgeon. She's been CEO Barbie. You know, she's done a lot in the STEM field. She's been a computer engineer, a video games developer. She has explored Mars. You know, I mean, she probably did that on a weekend. A firefighter. Did I say firefighter? Yeah, she's been a firefighter. Oh, of course, she's been a journalist. And she has also run for the president of the United States. And not just there. She then also ran Germany. She was a chancellor of Germany for a while, as you do. And in between those things, of course, she's ran, you know, the Barbie Dream House. She has a long-term relationship with Ken. Not quite sure what Ken does.
So, who's ready for Ken's dream tour?
I think Ken may be a very, very supportive house partner because obviously Barbie's very busy. I mean, oh, here's an interesting fact for you. Do you know that Barbie's name is not actually Barbie? No, her name is Barbara Millicent. Yeah, okay, just putting it out there. I'm just going to get my fact of information here. Look, I've been reading things. Is there anything else that... Oh, and of course, there was the... she had a top 1997 hit that was produced in homage to Barbie, and it was Aqua's Barbie Girl. I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world. Life is plastic, fantastic. You can brush my hair, undress me everywhere. Imagination, life is your creation. Barbie being the ever-changing powerhouse that she is, became more diverse in the late 2010s. Barbie started her own YouTube channel, which is at Barbie Style. She has over 151 minutes of content on her Barbie YouTube channel. And in 2015, she launched her own vlog. So, on this, I have included one of my personal favourite Barbie toys that I had as a child. And it was the Barbie Magic Van. Now, my nanny, who is here, and I'm hoping I can get this in shot where she won't reflect. My nanny, who is always at my desk, she brought me the Barbie Magic Van for my birthday 1 year. And she also brought me the Barbie with the really long hair. Why can I not remember her name? And she came with hair gel. And then I had another Barbie, and she had really long hair. And if you sprayed her hair with water, her hair turned pink. I need to investigate what Barbie they were, and I will insert them in here now. But I definitely had the Barbie, because she almost had like this neon, very 90s clothes, skin tight top, and she had this hair that went all the way down literally to her ankles, and that was like one of the selling points. I think she was the most popular Barbie, but that was brought along with the Barbie Magic Van. Now I have a little treat for you. I'm now going to insert the original advert of the Barbie Magic Van.
It's going places and taking all our friends. That's why we're into Barbie's Magic Voyager.
Magic?
Sure, just watch.
Sunny places, smiling faces, Barbie's Magic Voyager. Oh, oh, like magic. Oh, fantastic. Barbie and her fun car with the Magic Voyager.
We're into Barbie!
Barbie's new Magic Voyager with detachable fun car. Assembly required, doll sold separately. New from Mattel.
Now, you've seen the Magic Van. How old does that advert seem? So, I'm now going to move on. I'm now going to stick this in. I have some rather fabulous, beautiful washi from Grace at Udama Doodles that is going to go on this spread. And then I'm going to bring Joan in. And then I'm going to get on with the typing. See you all on the other side.
Everything's right somehow.
Here she is, the lady herself. She's had a nice summer. She came to Wales, went on a little adventure in Wales. She enjoyed it thoroughly. I just need to adjust the camera a little bit because I need Joan to be down here to type. So I need to move my camera. Here we go. Me and Joan are done. This doesn't go very well, this part, is it? There we go, we can kind of see, we can kind of see what's going on. There we go. We're all done. I think that was relatively record time. Thank you for bearing with me while I've had this little break. I will be back to uploading Prattle and Plans. Please, please go over and have a look at Sarah's YouTube channel. Please remember, it's just my typewriter, and you will experience the full story around this little beauty. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much again for watching, and I will see you again next week for another Prattle and Plan. Take care, everybody. Bye.